Welcome to our Leaseweb Object Storage demo. In this video, we'll sign in as a tenant, create a bucket, and generate an access key. First, we'll sign in to the Storage Grid Tenant Manager. Once logged in, navigate to the bucket's creation section and create a bucket name. Select your region and create bucket. Now navigate to My Access Keys. Click Create Key and then Create Access Key. Here you can copy your access key ID and your secret access key. Next, we'll configure our local clients to connect to the bucket using the access keys we just created. We'll use a client called S3CMD. Open the terminal, and if S3CMD isn't installed, install it. Run the command on screen. Now enter the access key, secret key, region, endpoint, and bucket name template. Set an encryption password for client-side encryption. Now let's upload three types of files: unencrypted, client-side encrypted, and server-side encrypted. First, upload an unencrypted file. Next, upload a client-side encrypted file. And finally, upload a server-side encrypted file. We can list all the files uploaded to the bucket here, and this command will display the list of the three files uploaded. Let's access object storage through a browser. If you navigate to the URL on screen, you can see the list of files. Notice that unencrypted and server-side encrypted files can be viewed, while the client-side encrypted file is unreadable. Here's the client-side encrypted file we downloaded earlier. When we open the downloaded encrypted file, you can clearly see it is unreadable. Let's set a security policy to prevent unauthorized access. Upload private access.json using the command on screen. After setting the security policy, the files are no longer accessible. When we refresh the browser, you can see an access denied message. We'll now upload a policy that allows public access. Upload public access.json using the command seen on screen. The browser can now list and download files again. Now, if we refresh the browser, the files are accessible. You can also download files using the client. You do this by running the command as seen on screen. Here, we can see the downloaded and decrypted files using the configured encryption password. Now let's set a policy for partial access. Upload partial access.json using the command seen on screen. Here, you can now see the statement of your partial access policy. Make sure you verify that your partial access restrictions are in place. If we download server-side encryption file, you can see it is denied, but the file is allowed. Now list the bucket contents. Finally, we'll remove a file from the bucket. Run the command as seen on screen, list files before and after deletion to confirm removal, and that's it.